Hello, hello, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Kesia Vongi, and today we're just getting right into the video. So we are just going to turn this beautiful shirt into a nice cute crop top, which you're going to see, which is going to be something like this. So if you want to know how to turn a shirt into a cute crop top, please stay tuned as I teach you how to do that. Getting right into our video, so this was our shirt. Our shirt is long sleeves, so we are just going to measure everything up. So first things first, measurements are always important. Measure yourself first, measure the length of your shoulders. So the length of my shoulders was 40, as you are going to see what I'm going to do. The length of my shoulders was 40, and I'm just going to divide that by 2. And you always want to make sure that you cut the shirt in a curve and not in a straight line, because if you do cut your shirt in a straight line, it will be small in the arms and you cannot wear the shirt. So always make sure that you curve your shirt as you are cutting it, because that's important. It will allow your arms to perfectly fit into the shirt. And yeah, so it is important. As you can see here, I was just making sure that I was getting the measurements right, and I just went in with my pencil to make sure that I was doing the right thing, because once you cut the wrong measurements, it means that the whole project is messed up, because the thing with fabric, once it's gone, it's gone. You can't put it back. When you put it back, it's just going to look like you are a joke. So I just went in with my measuring tape, make sure that everything was in place. So I was just going to cut the shirt right at the bottom of the first button. I just divided 40 by 2, which is 20, the length of my shoulders, and then I just made sure that everything was in place as I got my scissors to go in and just cut off the top part, because these guys like have been arguing a lot, didn't belong together, and I just helped them to officially get their divorce. And yeah, so I just went in with my scissors to cut the top part, and these people were officially divorced, like the top part was not part of the shirt anymore, and peace was just prevailing everywhere. You know how these things go. So the top part is gone. Video, I just cut off the top part, and I just wanted the length of the casing that I wanted to make, where we're going to put our elastic to make sure that the top is tight enough. So I just measured 2 inches for the casing, one inside and one outside, and I also just left 1/2 inch for the seam allowance. So it's always important for you to leave seam allowance, because if you do not leave seam allowance, it will mean that your casing will be very small and the elastic will be too tight and your shirt will just be uncomfortable, which is something that you do not want. So always make sure that the measurements are right, take the casing measurements right, and leave seam allowance. As you can see here, so I was just making sure that all the measurements were right before I could do anything. And after doing that, after officially getting all the right measurements, I just went in with my pins to just make sure that everything was pinned in place. Pins are very important. Like, if you do not have pins, it's just like you are just not living the life of a designer. Like, you don't know how to do things. Like, how do you sew things without your pins? So you just need to put your pins together and make sure that they're in place, because the pins will just make sure that everything is in place as you sew. You do not go in too far or go out too far, so make sure that your pins are in place. And I'll emphasize the recipe for you to do anything. And also, I just went in to measure my arms, and as you can see there, I cut the first arm, and also I just made sure that I aligned them together, because I wanted them to be of the same length. Because if you go in and cut both arms separately, you might just find that the other arm is longer than the other, and that's not something that you want, because if it's shorter, girl, you're not taking back that fabric. So always make sure that you align the arms. When you cut the first one, you get the right measurements, and you go to the second one, you align them, and you cut so that you have the exact same measurements, which will help you to just do things better. And yeah, so this was basically our shirt. So we made measurements for the bottom part also, because I did not want the shirt to be too long, because this of the shoulder top is a crop top. So I just went in to make measurements on how long I wanted it to be from the bottom So you're just going to see everything as I measure everything. Please pay particular attention so that you should be able also to do the right thing when you are sewing your shirt. So pins are always important. As you can see there, I'm going in with my pins to just make sure that everything is pinned up and everything is in place. You do not want to just do things like a mad person. Like, if you like your fabric, you are just going to do things right. Always pin your things up before you sew. And for those people that do not have sewing machines, you can just do everything for yourself. You cut, you pin it up, and when you're done, you can just take to your tailor. It's going to be much cheaper because the tailor doesn't have to do all the work. So you do everything, you cut, you make all the measurements, you put the pins, and you just give instructions to the tailor to just cut, and it's just going to save you a whole bunch of time and money. So always make sure that you put everything in place before you take it to the tailor, because yeah, you know what you want, but the tailor doesn't want, like, you just don't want everything to be messed up because the tailor doesn't want to understand your type of fashion. And sometimes they do understand, you just miss it when it comes to maybe measurements and what. So I would rather you do that yourself at home, and you just put everything in place so that as you go to the tailor, you can just give them instructions on what to do. Because, bruh, you don't want to take your beautiful shirt to take it to the tailor because the tailor didn't do the right thing. We all know that feeling. We know how it goes. So I just made sure that the bottom part will had the right measurements. So I took off about 2 inches. Just make sure that I had the top to the length that I really wanted it to be, as you can see here. So please stay with me as we just do everything and stay tuned, and yeah.
Staring at herself in the mirror on the restroom door. Voices in her head that mirror what she's heard before. All the things they said to hold her back, they never seem to leave her head and tend to keep her mind at war. All the things they said to hold her back, they keep her locked inside of all the times when she's been hurt before. Her eyes are swollen as she tries to hold her tears back. Her hands are shaking.
Yeah, so everything was just pinned up and beautiful, as you can see. All the measurements were right. I just took everything to the machine so that we can just do the magic, and you can have the beautiful crop top that you desire to have. Yeah, so sewing machine to make all the casings for both arms, that on the below part where we're just going to insert our elastic so that our crop top can be tight and nice, as you're going to see what we are going to do at the end of this video. So one thing that I have learned is that everything has got issue, like any issue. So look at this, we are back with it. We just sewed everything up, so all the casings were made. And always make sure to leave a space where you're going to insert your elastic from, because if you do not leave that space, it means that you're not. So on all parts and the below part, you need to leave that space so that you can be able to insert your elastic, as you just want to be happy with it. Yeah, so I just went in to make measurements of my arms, my shoulders, and how tight I wanted it to be on the bottom part. Yeah, and I started inserting the elastic, as you can see from the video.
The top
I just went in to make sure that the casing measurements were correct and the sizes were okay for the space to use when inserting the elastic, so that I didn't have to struggle. So always make sure that you leave that space for the casing and use a safety pin for elastic, so you can just put the safety pin at the end of the elastic and then you use the safety pin to insert the elastic in the casing. And make sure to not pull the elastic excessively, because all of it might just go into your casing and you might just spend more time inserting it than you would like to do. Yeah, so as you can see, I was just trying to insert the elastic on the top part of the crop top. Stay tuned as we just finish up our crop top.
Staring at herself in the mirror on the restroom door. Voices in her head that mirror what she's heard before. All the things they said to hold her back, they never seem to leave her head and tend to keep her mind at war. All the things they said to hold her back, they keep her locked inside of all the times when she's been hurt before. Her eyes are swollen as she tries to hold her tears back. Her hands are shaking and her palms are sweating as she says, I don't wanna listen to a word you say. Tell me what I can pick up. And I've been looking forward to this day, the day I prove you wrong.
I just made sure that I try to distribute the elastic evenly. So make sure that the measurements for your elastic are correct, because when you get wrong measurements for the elastic, if the elastic is very small, it means that your top is going to be very tight, which is going to make you a lot more uncomfortable. And you know, an off-shoulder top just needs to be comfortable. So make sure that the measurements are right so that you can look good and feel good.
Staring at herself in the mirror on the restroom door. Voices in her head that mirror what she's heard before. All the things they said to hold her back, they never seem to leave her head and tend to keep her mind at war. All the things they said to hold her back, they keep her locked inside of all the times when she's been hurt before. Her eyes are swollen as she tries to hold her tears back. Her hands are shaking and her palms are sweating as she says, I don't wanna listen to a word you say. Tell me what I can pick up. And I've been looking forward to this day, the day I prove you wrong.
So I just went back to my machine. I just made sure that I closed all the small gaps that I'd left to insert the elastic. I closed everything up. As you can see, it's nice, neat and clean. As you're going out with your friends to watch a movie, to do anything, you can just rock this shirt with a short skirt, with a trouser, and yeah, this is basically our nice crop top. So I'm just going to go ahead and try it on so that you see how it looks. And there, that's our nice crop top. So I just tried it on with some black jeans sandals. So you can just wear this when you're going out to the movie. I like the way the buttons came out. They were so cute, and I like the texture of the shirt. Like, it just looked perfect when I turned it into a crop top. So you can just turn your old shirts, even new ones. You can even get bigger ones and turn them into this beautiful crop top. So I, right now I can just go anywhere because, oh, just look at it. Look at it and see how beautiful it looks. Yeah, so this is our video for the day. Please do not forget to subscribe, like, and comment as usual. Please turn on the notification button, and I'll be back again for another video. Hope to see you again. Bye-bye. And do not forget to follow me on Instagram so that you can see how I style this cute crop top.